Hey guys, welcome back to our repair guys. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. In today's video guys, we'll be working on a BMW and we have a code 9389, which is for a seatbelt pretensioner. Stay with us guys and we'll show you how to fix that now. We're demonstrating on a BMW 3 series here, generation 2005 to 2013. We have guys more than 200 videos on that BMW. In addition, we're going to have more BMWs on the channel, 5 series E46 as well, E65. So let me show you quick now. I'll go ahead, start the car and show you how the airbag light is on. Okay, I'm inside the car now. I'll go ahead, start it, check it out now. Airbag light will stay on, so we need to go ahead and figure out what's wrong with it now. So I have the OBD scanner connected already to the OBD port. We'll have it listed in the description of the video below if you need to figure out what we're using guys. Nothing sponsored here, just a product purchased by us and we really like it. So you can see just a quick introduction how many cars you can diagnose with that thing. Okay, let's go back and I'll just click VIN number auto detect. It's going to read the VIN number of the car and tell us exactly which model and which engine we have. You can do that manually, but it will take you some time and you have to really know if it's an N52, N53, N54 engine and all that stuff, which could be a little bit complicated with all the different configurations. So this is our VIN number, we confirm OK. This is the BMW N52 engine 325XI. We are waiting now. Until it loads all the data, so it will take a few seconds and we'll come back to it. Okay, this is the next screen, it's loading now. So let us show you how easy it is to diagnose the system. In the meantime, let me make sure that the ignition is on of the vehicle without the engine running. Okay, to see where I left the key. So I'll go ahead, plug the key in, just push start the button now. Perfect, and we'll just leave the ignition on while it's loading all the data so we can access the modules now. We also have the message on the screen that it says passenger restraint system, there is a problem. Now we'll go to diagnostics, we'll select control unit here. Next, we're going to select body. The airbag is part of the body system and right here is the airbag module. We're going to read the code. Okay, not present. And right here guys, we have that code, 9389. Belt tensioner driver. Now, we have a video how to test. This is the belt tensioner. Okay, we have a video how to test them guys. The procedure is super simple. All you need is an ohm meter and it will take you only a few seconds to do that, maybe a minute. So we have the video, check it out. But now, since we have three codes that relate to the side airbag. Okay, you can see right here is the side airbag in the seat. Belt tensioner, which is part of the seat, and the seat belt catch as well. Okay, the seat belt catch is where it goes in, it detects if you have the belt on and off. All that tells us that there was something wrong with the connection of the seat. So we need to go under the seat and check out our connector, make sure it's not loose or anything, it's not corroded, and we'll see if that fixes the problem. So this is for the driver's seat pretensioner. I'll go under the seat now. Okay, that's where the connector for your seat is. Okay, this one, it's supposed to be in that bracket right here. And ours is not, it's supposed to be there. Now, it tells me that something probably was loose. Okay, and I'm going to go ahead, disconnect it. So that black thing, okay, needs to come out and it's going to kick it out. Now will be the time to inspect all the little pins inside to make sure nothing's bent. And also, you have to make sure that they're not corroded. Sometimes if you live in a climate that has more humidity, that could happen. So I would go ahead,
reconnected now. Okay, and I'll install it in that bracket here, so that way, okay, it's not going to be in the way of the seat and will not damage our cables. Because if it's a damaged cable, that's not good. So let's see if that fixes the code now. With the ignition on, okay, I accidentally exited the module. I'll go ahead, okay, and select body, airbag again, and we're going to erase the codes now. We confirm that we want to. Erase was successful, okay, escape. So let's go ahead and see. Okay, airbag light is not on. I'll turn the engine off, the ignition off, and I'll go ahead, start it now. And as you can see, there is no airbag light on at all. So that definitely, guys, fixed that problem, but always check your cables, and if that doesn't fix the code, check your pretensioner. And we have the video how to replace it and how to test it. So thank you for watching. Please subscribe and see you guys next time.